There's a really simple concept that I want you to know about any complex fraction. And I think if you can understand this one little concept, then that will make your life being able to simplify complex fractions so much easier. So that simple concept goes like this. In this case, we have a fraction, right? And we have a numerator as well as a denominator. However, in the denominator, notice there's another fraction. And we want to get rid of the fraction, right? We don't want too many fractions. We want one numerator, one denominator, no more fraction bars, okay? So if we want to get rid of a fraction, how do you do that, right? A fraction has a numerator and denominator. How do you get rid of that denominator? Well, what you need to do is you need to find a number that your denominator is going to evenly divide into. 2 does not evenly divide into 1. So what is the number that 2 evenly divides into? No, 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 check that. What is the smallest number that 2 evenly divides into? And you probably say, well, itself, 2, right? So if I multiply by a 2 on my denominator, again, to keep it equivalent with fractions, you have to multiply 2 in the numerator as well. Now, check this out. 2 evenly divides into 2 one time. 1 times 1 is just going to be 1. And therefore, I'm left with a simplified version of 2. And you might have already known that, like 1 divided by 2 half, or 1 half is just going to be 2, multiplied by the reciprocal, you know, in that kind of case. The thing that I want you to understand, if you want to get rid of your fraction, you've got to find something that your denominator evenly divides into. So in this case, we have a lot of denominators, right? We have this big denominator, and then inside that big denominator, we have a denominator here, x minus 4, and denominator over here, x minus 4. So what I want you to understand is like, all right, let's find what is it, what is the smallest expression in this case that x minus 4 divides into. And it might be kind of confusing. You're like, I don't know, what does x minus 4 divide into? I'm not really sure, but I know it always is going to divide into itself, right? So yeah, guess what? Let's just multiply here everything by an x minus 4 on the left-hand side as well as on the right-hand side. Oh, I'm sorry, in the denominator as well as the numerator. Okay, now we do have to be a little careful here because we do have an expression here, 1 minus. So therefore, I'm going to put parentheses here because I do have to distribute that straight across. However, just like 2 divides into 2 one time, x minus 4 divides into this x minus 4 one time. So that's where I'm going to be left with a 3. Over here, the x minus 4 times 1 is going to leave me with an x minus 4. And then here, the x minus 4s are going to divide out. And that's going to leave me with a minus a 2. Now what I can do is just simplify this expression a little bit more. I can do x minus 4 minus 2 is going to be x minus 6. So it's a 3 divided by an x minus 6. If I want to be a little bit extra special, I can write the restricted values. I know that 4 cannot be in the denominator, or x cannot equal a 4, because that would make my denominator 0 over here, as well as x cannot equal a 6, because that would make my final simplified answer a 0 as well. So hopefully you have this basic understanding of how to simplify complex fractions, and this video gave you some value. Because in the next video, I'm going to show you the approach that you need to understand when simplifying complex fractions when you have different denominators.